from that unit, okay, the drugs which are used for cardiovascular system. Okay, so I've completed all the topics and also all the units also I have completed. Okay, all my assigned units I have completed. If today you go and check the syllabus, if you feel like I have not completed or I've missed a topic from any unit, then you let me know. Okay, so that I will start in the next class. Okay, but from my side, I feel like I have completed all the topics. Okay, and also my syllabus will be complete today. Okay, so this is the last topic, that is hypolipidemic agents. So before going into hypolipidemic agents, first we have to know what are cholesterol and what are the triglycerides. Okay, so people who eat lots of fatty foods, oily foods, okay, like butter, ghee, okay, all these oily foods, fried foods, okay, so you will have a lot of cholesterol. Yes, so first of all, let me teach you about the triglycerides and the cholesterol. Okay, so lipoprotein, it is a combination of triglyceride or cholesterol with the apolipoprotein. Okay, so in here, this lipoprotein, okay, lipoprotein is basically of the fats. Okay, it consists of two things. It consists of cholesterol and it consists of triglycerides. Okay, and they are they are formed together with the help of another protein that we call it as apolipoprotein. Okay, so you can see in this picture also. Okay, so phospholipids and apolipoproteins are together combined, and it helps the cholesterol and glycerides to be formed together in the lipoprotein. Okay, then what are these lipoproteins? Okay, you must have heard about LDL, HDL, VLDL. Okay, so these are the short forms. So in lipoproteins, you have very low density lipoproteins. Then you have low density lipoprotein. You also have high density lipoprotein. Okay, so VLDL, the full form is very low density lipoprotein. It means that these are the very dangerous lipids of the very dangerous fats that can cause cardiovascular problems. Okay, it can lead to atherosclerosis. Okay, it can lead to acute coronary syndrome, where in the coronary arteries there can be plaque formation. Wo jo plaque formation hai, that is because of these lipoproteins. Okay, so VLDL, very low density lipoprotein, it is produced by the liver. It transports the endogenous lipids to the cells. So this is I can say this is a bad cholesterol or a bad fatty lipids. Okay, so what do? They transport the endogenous lipids, okay, to the cells, directly to the cells. Okay, so when there are their fats, when they are lipids, then it can cause plaque formation. Okay, and these are very dangerous, okay, for the heart. Then we also have another one, we call it as low density lipoprotein or LDL. Okay, low density lipoprotein, these are also a little bit bad cholesterol, or you can say the bad fatty acids of the fat, lipids. Okay, so these also can cause they can cause atherosclerosis, okay, or they can cause any cardiovascular disease condition. Then another, we have the HDL, high density lipoprotein. These are good cholesterol, or we can say good cholesterol, or they do not harm much for the cardiovascular system. Okay, they do not harm that at a very high rate to the patient. Okay, so they are responsible for recycling of the cholesterol. So HDL are good cholesterol. They are not so harmful cholesterol, and they are responsible for the recycling of the cholesterol. Okay, they are also known as good cholesterol. So these are the three important lipoproteins: VLDL, very low density lipoproteins, which are the worst cholesterol. Okay, they are the worst fatty lipids. They cause a lot of these atherosclerosis disease condition. They cause they are responsible for the plaque formation in the arteries. Okay, that is VLDL. Then we also have LDL, low density lipoprotein, that is also a very bad cholesterol. Then also we have the high HDL, high density lipoprotein. These are very good cholesterol. They are not so harmful and they are responsible for the recycling of the cholesterol. Okay, so these are the three important lipoproteins. Is it clear? Anybody has any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so you can see in this picture also. Okay, so we have the, first of all, we have the chylomicron. Okay, then we have the very low density lipoprotein. Then there is a LDL and there is a HDL, high density lipoprotein. Then now coming to the hypolipidemic agents. Okay, so when there is any plaque formation in the coronary arteries or any arteries in the body, okay, so if there is any plaque formation, then we have to give some medicines so that plaque formation will dissolve, it will break, okay, it will be destroyed. So those medicines we call it as hypolipidemic drugs. Okay, so the introduction is that cardiovascular and cerebrovascular ischemic disease are the leading cause of morbidity and mortality. Okay, so in India also, atherosclerosis is very common. Okay, that is a plaque formation in the or fatty lipids in the arteries, in the coronary arteries. Okay, so it affects the heart. Okay, it damages the heart. So because of this plaque formation, patient will have heart attack and will have angina pain. So cardiovascular disease also can cause a lot of death. Okay, it causes a lot of death. It is a leading cause for death and also for sickness. Then we also have the cerebrovascular ischemic disease like a stroke or a CVA, cerebrovascular accident. Okay, so in CVA, or we call it as stroke. Okay, so when there is a plaque or when there is a blood clot formation in any of the arteries, it can be in the carotid arteries. Okay, so that will obstruct the blood flow to the brain. Brain tissues will not get oxygenated blood, they will not get tissue perfusion. Okay, so what happened is the brain tissues will die. Okay, so when brain tissues will die, then obviously patient your mental activity hai, that will not function. Okay, so that will cause death. So cardiovascular relating to the heart problem and cerebrovascular leading to the brain. Okay, so these disease conditions are the leading cause of morbidity and mortality, that is sickness and death. Then dyslipidemia is the major cause of ischemia. Okay, that is lipids or fats present in the blood. Okay, so that because of the fats in the blood, fats in the veins or fats in the blood vessels, then proper blood flow will not be there and that can cause ischemia. Then medicines to treat these conditions, we call it as hypolipidemic drugs. Okay, so hypolipidemic drugs, they lower the levels of lipids and lipoproteins in the blood. So the medicines that we can treat so that the lipid proteins, the lipoproteins level will be reduced, so we can give hypolipidemic agents. Okay, so lipids are transported in plasma in lipoproteins, which are associated with other proteins that we call it as apoproteins. So this I have explained in the previous slide. Okay, that cholesterol and triglycerides, okay, they form the lipoproteins with the help of apoproteins. Okay, so this is the introduction of hypolipidemic agent. Then what is the definition of hypolipidemic agent? These are the drugs or the medicines which are used in the treatment of atherosclerosis and hyperlipidemia. Atherosclerosis is a cardiovascular disease condition where there is plaque formation in the coronary arteries. Okay, and coronary artery is responsible for transporting oxygenated blood to the heart. Okay, the heart muscles also, they need oxygenated blood. Okay, so that they will do their action. They will pump the blood. Okay, so heart is not getting any oxygenated blood. So what will happen? That there will be heart failure. So atherosclerosis, in such condition, we will give hypolipidemic drugs. Okay, so jo bhi plaque formation hai in the coronary artery, that we can reduce or we can resolve it by giving these medicine. Then also hyperlipidemia, that is fats which are present in the blood, okay, in the blood vessels. So in this condition we can give hypolipidemic agent. Is this clear with everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now coming to the mechanism of action of hypolipidemic agent. Okay, so these hypolipidemic agents, what do? They stop or they inhibit the synthesis of cholesterol in the liver. So we know that cholesterol is produced by the liver. Okay, so these medicines, hypolipidemic agents, okay, they will try to stop the synthesis. They will not allow the liver to produce the cholesterol. So they will not allow the synthesis of cholesterol in the liver. Also, they stop the transfer of triglycerides from the liver to the plasma. Okay, so not only it blocks or it obstructs or it stops the synthesis of cholesterol in the liver, lekin ye jo transport hai, okay, the carrying of the triglycerides from the liver to the plasma, okay, because the triglycerides will they will pass on from the liver to the plasma. They will have to transport. So these medicines that we are giving, it will try to stop the transport of triglycerides from the liver to the destination, that is the plasma. And also third action is it blocks the HMG coenzyme reductase in the liver, preventing the cholesterol synthesis. So it blocks these this HMG COA reductase. This is an enzyme. Okay, so it does not allow this enzyme to be produced in the liver. Therefore, there will be no cholesterol synthesis. Okay, so what happened is the cholesterol level will be reduced, the lipids, the fats will be reduced. Okay, so this is the mechanism. There are three mechanisms of hypolipidemic agent. Okay, the first action is it stops the synthesis of cholesterol where in the liver. That is the first action. Second action, it stops the transfer of triglycerides from the liver to the plasma. That is the second action. Third, it blocks the HMG COA reductase enzyme, okay, in the liver. It does not allow these enzymes to be produced, to be active. Okay, so this will help in preventing the cholesterol synthesis. So these are the three actions of hypolipidemic agent. Is this clear with the mechanism of action? Anybody has any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so now coming to the examples of the medicine. Okay, so in hypolipidemic agent, okay, so there are medicines like tablet, atorvastatin, then we have the simvastatin, then we have the, there's also another medicine like lovastatin, clofibrate, and cholestipol. Okay, so these are some of the medicines under hypolipidemic agent. Okay, so the very most common is the Atorvas, or we call it as the brand name is Atorvas and the generic name is Atorvastatin. The dose we can give to the patient is 10 to 20 mg daily. Then simvastatin, we give the dose is 10 to 40 mg at night daily. So this is only at night, okay? Bedtime, HS. Then lovastatin, this is also given at night. The dose is 10 to 20 mg daily. Then clofibrate, 1 to 2 gram daily per orally individual dose. Then also another medicine is the cholestipol. Okay, so cholestipol, we can give the dose that 15 to 30 gram daily. So these are the doses of these medicines of hypolipidemic agent. Okay, so by giving these medicines, what happen is the lipids, the high level of lipids in the blood, that will be decreased. And if there is any plaque formation in the coronary arteries or in the carotid artery, so it will, you know, it will try to dissolve these plaque, or it'll try to dissolve the fatty lipids. Okay, is this clear with the drugs and the doses?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so whenever you see in the wards, okay, whenever you see this tablet Atorvast or Atorvastatin, so you remember that it is a hypolipidemic agent. Okay, it does not allow the cholesterol to be synthesized in the liver. Then you can see here also, okay, so Atorvastatin, Pravastatin, Fluvastatin, okay, Lovastatin, Simvastatin, these are the hypolipidemic agents. Okay, so they have I've explained about the mechanism of action. Okay, so all these the cholesterol is synthesized in the liver. Okay, so these medicines, they do not allow the cholesterol to be synthesized in the liver. They do not allow the transport of triglyceride from the liver to the blood or to the plasma. And also, it does not allow the HMG coenzyme enzymes reductase, the enzymes which are responsible for the synthesis of cholesterol. So it blocks the HMG reductase enzyme. Okay, so it does not allow these to be active. So these are the the functions of hypolipidemic agent. Okay. So whenever patient is having plaque formation or whenever patient is suffering from atherosclerosis, then patient will always have angina pain. Okay. And ultimately patient can have heart attack. So what are the indications when we should give hypolipidemic agent? Okay. Number one, CAD, coronary arteries disease. Okay. So if patient is having plaque formation in the coronary arteries, okay, so we can give in that condition. Then hyperlipidemia also, the level of the fats or the level of the lipids is very high in the blood, then in such condition also we can give hypolipidemic agent. Then hypertriglyceridemia, when the triglycerides is very high, when the level of triglycerides is very high in the blood. Then we also give in secondary prevention of cardiovascular events. Then we also give in atherosclerosis, in hypercholesterolemia, that is when the cholesterol level is very high in the blood, and increase in severe level of HDL. Okay, so these are some of the indications of hypolipidemia agents. Now coming to the contraindication, when we should not give these medicines. Number one, if patient is hypersensitive to the medicine, okay, very sensitive, having allergic reactions to the medicine, then we should stop the medicine and we should not continue. Number two, if patient is having a high level of LFT test, okay, all, the values in the LFT test, they are all high, okay. It's more than the normal level, then in such condition also we should not give hypolipidemic agent. Then we should not give if patient is having any liver damage or renal or kidney dysfunction. Then we should cautiously use in females who are pregnant and who are or breastfeeding women or those who are lactating. Okay, so we should be very careful while giving in pregnant women and lactating women, for those who are breastfeeding their babies. Okay, so these are some of the contraindication and precautions for the hypolipidemic agent. Is this clear to everyone? Anybody
yes,
has
ma'am.
Any doubts?
No.
Okay, now coming to the adverse effects. Okay, so what can be the the signs and symptoms that will show on the patient's body after administering or after getting the hypolipidemic agent? Number one, patient can have headache, photosensitivity, that is very sensitive to any light. Okay, then progression of cataracts, patient can have cataract also, insomnia, not able to sleep properly. Then blurring of vision, not able to see any object clearly. Nausea, vomiting, patient can have diarrhea, okay, constipation, dyspepsia, that is excessive thirst, feeling very thirsty. Then rhabdomyolysis, then abdominal cramps, flatulence, hypersensitivity reaction, and myopathy. Okay, so these are some of the adverse effects of hypolipidemic agent. Then coming to the drug interaction. Okay, so if we are using hypolipidemic agent with erythromycin, or we are using with cyclosporin or nicotinic acid, okay, so it can increase the risk of rhabdomyolysis and myopathy. Then it may increases the digoxin levels, okay, and if we are using with concurrent use of simvastatin, atorvastatin with warfarin sodium. Okay, so warfarin, I've told you that it is an anticoagulant. Okay, so if you are using warfarin with atorvastatin, or if you are giving it with simvastatin, then it can increase the effects of warfarin. Therefore, blood clotting, okay, it will be damaged, or the blood clots will be dissolved. Okay, so these are some of the drug interactions with hypolipidemic agent. Then coming to the nursing responsibilities, okay, so we have to monitor the vitals of the patient. Okay, we have to check their temperature, check their pulse, respiratory rate, blood pressure, and also SpO2. Okay, then assess for any sign and symptoms, okay, or any side effects the patient is showing, okay, and also report to the doctor immediately if patient is having any side effects. Then perform LFT test before giving hypolipidemic agent. Okay, liver function test you have to perform. Then advise the patient to avoid any alcohol, avoid smoking, avoid illegal use of drugs. Okay, then these medicines should start only after diet therapy has proven ineffective. Okay, so we have to give after meals. Okay, then give lovastatin with evening meal because absorption is enhanced and cholesterol biosynthesis is greater in the evening. So this medicine lovastatin, that's why we give it at night time in the evening, okay, with the evening meal or with dinner. Then monitor liver function test. Like I said, liver function test is very important. If the levels are very high, then we should not give hypolipidemic agent. Then monitor the blood level of fat, soluble vitamins, serum cholesterol also should be checked. Triglyceride levels also should be checked. Okay, and LFT test should be performed during the therapy. Okay, so these are some of the nursing responsibilities. Apart from this, advise the patient not to avoid consuming of fats, avoid consuming fried foods, butter, ghee, all these oily foods, avoid all these spicy food also, okay? And tell the patient to perform exercises every day, okay? And you can perform yoga, okay? Light exercises also is very important, Okay, and drink lots of water, lots of fluids should be taken. Okay, and if patient is suffering from any side effects, should be noted, should be reported to the doctor. Okay, so these are some of the nursing responsibilities for hypolipidemic agents. Is this clear with everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, so I will send you the PowerPoint. Okay, you have a look at the PowerPoint.